Well, hi, and thanks for stopping by the Pellets and Pistons Air Gun Channel. It's been kind of an overcast day today, but just as I started the camera, the sun broke through the clouds, and it looks like it's going to clear up for the afternoon. And I'm out here doing a little shooting with a new gun I picked up. And what is this gun? Well, it's the Hatsan Model 135. This is a brake barrel air rifle. It's a gas ram air rifle. But what makes it really unique is that I ordered it in the largest caliber, to my knowledge, that you can get a piston-powered air rifle in, which is 30 caliber. That's a huge bore. I'll show you a little thing I made up that gives you an indication of the different size calibers that are available for piston-powered rifles. And you'll be amazed at the size of that 30 caliber pellet. So take a look at this. So while you're looking at that, we're going to go over the rifle a little bit, and we'll give you a look at that as well. So it's a 30 caliber gas ram rifle. The factory claims up to 550 feet per second, and they claim it's right around 30 foot-pounds of muzzle energy. That's a lot for a piston-powered air gun. That's an awful lot. It comes in at 47.2 inches long. This gun is big. It weighs 9.9 pounds. This gun is heavy. They claim a 50-pound cocking effort, and it's at least 50 pounds. Let me tell you, it takes a lot to bring that gun all the way down until the sear engages. It takes an awful lot. This isn't for kids or small frame people. You're not going to be able to pull that barrel down. I almost guarantee it. Even with two hands, a small frame person is going to have a hard time. It's got a pretty nice Turkish walnut stock. These scratch real easy. They are kind of easily damaged, but it's very attractive. It's got checkering on it, which is better than I've seen on some of their other guns, at least in the grip section, but it doesn't protrude much. It's not very sharp. It's there more for looks, I think, than anything else. It has an adjustable comb and has an adjustable butt plate, which is awful nice. It's got the Quattro trigger, which is not my favorite trigger. They claim it to be a super duper trigger. Extremely hard pull. It likes to be pulled backward and upward at the same time. You'll get a little better pull out of it that way, but it's still going to average somewhere between 4 and 6 pounds. It's not a great trigger, but for a gun like this, you're not looking for precision, although from what I've seen with the right pellets, it can be pretty precise. But what you want when you buy a gun like this, you just want raw power. That's the only reason you buy a gun like this. And I bought it for the channel because I thought you guys would get a kick out of it. So today we're just going to play around with it a little bit, and we'll do another video once I get a pellet that actually functions well in the gun. When I ordered it, I ordered Vortex Strike pellets. These are the Hatsan pellets that they offer for this rifle, and the pellets don't fit the bore. The skirt on a pellet stands so proud. And I'll show you a picture of that. I'll take a picture and I'll insert that into the video later. But you'll be amazed how much of the pellet is still protruding when you push it as far in with your thumb as you can possibly push it. And what I had to do is make what essentially is a bullet starter, similar to what you'd use on a muzzle-loading rifle. I took a nylon toilet seat bolt and I ground it into a little taper so that it'll fit into the depression in the back of the pellet in the skirt. And I can take that pellet, and actually I have to give it a hard tap just to get it to start into the rifling. So obviously I'm not getting the best accuracy because I'm deforming those pellets a little bit. So we're not going to do any accuracy work with it today. We're just going to shoot my little 25-yard disc down there just so you can see what kind of reaction we get. And then we'll take a shot out to 60 yards and see if we can't ring that bell with these big, heavy 30 caliber pellets. So stick around. This ought to be fun. And thanks again for stopping by the Pellets and Pistons Air Gun Channel. Okay, so welcome back. We're here with the Hatsan Model 135 30 caliber gas ram air rifle. That's right, 30 caliber. Crazy. So anyway, if you're anything like me, you want to see what kind of numbers this thing's pushing. Even with these pellets that weigh 48.6 grains, and I got a feeling they're probably closer to 48 grains by the time I shave off enough lead to get them in the barrel. So we'll call them 48.6 when we do the calculation anyway, just to get an idea what the muzzle energy is. So at any rate, we're going to shoot 5 shots across the chronograph, and we'll get an average, and we'll give you the muzzle energy total as well. I'm going to try to line this thing up so I can see it and you can see it at the same time, and we'll zoom you up on the, I think you'll be able to see there. I'm not sure if I'm in your way. All right, I think that'll work. Maybe get a little closer. Okay guys, so what you're going to witness now is a 62-year-old man struggling to cock this rifle. And then we're going to load it up, and we're going to struggle to load a pellet, And then we're going to launch one across the chronograph. So when you cock this gun, hang on tight, be prepared, make sure it's firmly anchored, because it'll slide when you try to pull that barrel down. All right, so break it and then show it who's boss. All right. All right, again, the pellet stands proud. So what I've been doing is putting the gun in my lap like this with the barrel up against the bench. And I'll put my little starter in and give it a sharp whack, and that gets it about maybe, well, I don't know, maybe a little less than a quarter inch into the rifling. So I'm losing some velocity there, or gaining, I'm not sure if by adding a little more airspace what's happening, but I'm sure it's making a difference. So we're going to shoot 5 shots across that chronograph with these giant pellets. I hope you can see. If not, we'll record them and I'll just give you the numbers afterwards. It's got a automatic safety, which you pull backwards like you pull back a hammer. It also has some very nice plastic, but adjustable, fully adjustable sights with fiber optics. And I like the fiber optics for older eyes like mine. They're really nice. All right, this will be shot number one with the Hatson Model 135 and 30 caliber, shooting a 48.6 grain pellet. 532. Well, that's pretty close to what they're claiming. It's not bad at all. All right. We'll do shot number two. And again, we got this ridiculous loading system until I get some pellets. I think JSB makes a 30 caliber pellet, a Diabolo pellet that's ideal for this gun. So we're going to give that a shot and see if we can't get some accuracy. And then we'll revisit this rifle and we'll do some accuracy work with it and see what it's capable of. All right, shot number two. 412, that's weird. That's really strange. All right, well, maybe we'll do 6 shots and we'll throw that one out unless we get a repeat. That's just bizarre. I'm not sure what the difference was there. Maybe seating these pellets the way I'm seating them is causing a big variation in velocity. That's possible. All right. You see how hard I got to hit that just to get the pellet to start? So you know there's some deformation happening on the pellet. All right, shot number three. 539. Yeah, I think that was a fluke, that one in the 400s. Interesting, huh? I wonder what happened there. It had to have something to do with how we're loading these pellets. That's the only thing I can come up with. All right, this is shot number four. Shot number four. 427. Huh, I'm a little confused. Something's going on here. This will be shot number five. We're not going to throw those numbers out because obviously if it happened twice, it's something going on. So this will be our last shot. Let's see what we get again. And like I said, we're going to come back to this rifle, so we'll probably figure that out when we get some more pellets that actually fit. Shot five. 416. Yeah, I don't know what that's about. That's kind of weird. All right. At any rate, that didn't tell us too much, but once we get some good pellets, maybe we'll be able to get a little more consistency out of the velocity for the rifle. So now what we're going to do is cut away. I'm going to get the cameras rolling. We're going to zoom you up on my little disc at 25 yards, and we're going to take a couple of shots at that. I think you'll be impressed with how hard that 30 caliber delivers its energy to that little disc out there. So stick around. I'll be right back. Time for a little plinking fun. 25 yards. We're going to be shooting at that disc that you'll see in the small window here. And we're just going to try to get a reaction when we hit that thing. Oh yeah, it's a beast, let me tell you. Not for the faint of heart, but it is a novelty, and I thought the channel could use a little boost with a new rifle. So these were on sale. I picked it up very reasonably, and I'm kind of glad I did, because it's a lot of fun. It's not the kind of gun you're going to shoot all day, that's for sure, because it takes a lot out of you just to cock it. All right, this will be shot number one at that yellow disc out there. Watch this thing react. Shot one. It's crazy how much power it's got. Insane. All right, we'll do another shot or two at that disc, and then we'll refocus the cameras on the bell. And we'll let you hear how this thing rings that bell out there at 60 yards. If I can remember what the holdover is, it's pretty extreme with these heavy pellets. All right, we'll take another shot at that disc, shot number two. The disc is actually warping now. It's been hit with these heavy pellets so many times, it's actually starting to cup. All right, two, shot two. I like that, that's awesome. All right, when you get that kind of juice out of a piston rifle, it's just something to be remarked about. All right, one more time at that disc. Alrighty. Shot three. Makes quite a bit of noise too, doesn't it? All right, so we're gonna cut away. We'll come back. We'll ring the bell a couple of times and we'll call it a wrap. I'll be right back. All right, so here we go. We're gonna make a couple of 60-yard shots at that bell with this 30 caliber Hatsan Model 135. Now, as you saw, we got some crazy inconsistencies with velocity. Ooh, I gave it two hands on that one. And that means that we may get some elevation difference as well at 60 yards. So it might take me a couple of tries to figure out where to hold over. But that's what we're going to do. All right, let's ring the bell. This ought to be interesting. All right, neighbors, sorry. Right about there, I'm going to guess. Did you see that bell move? That's crazy. That is crazy. It's pretty loud too. Alright. So this afternoon, when I have a little time, I'm gonna get online, I'm gonna order some good 30 caliber pellets, and then we'll come back and we'll give this rifle a fair shake. Shot two at the bell. I actually saw the pellet lob in and hit the bell that time through the scope. We listened to the delay between the gun firing and that the pellet finally striking that bell. It's remarkable how long it takes to get there compared to some of my other air rifles. All right, and this will be the last shot at the bell, shot number three. All right, folks, that's the Hatsan Model 135 and 30 caliber. What a fun little gun. It's not the kind of thing that's for everyday shooting, but if you already have a couple of air guns in your collection and you're just looking for something to play with that's got some serious power, check this one out. It's pretty good and it's affordable. You can pick one up pretty cheap. At any rate, I want to thank you folks for stopping by the Pellets and Pistons Airgun channel. If you haven't subscribed already, please do that. Give me a thumbs up if you enjoy the video and hit that bell to be reminded of future videos. Thanks again, folks. Have a great day.